In this part of the tutorial, I am going to show you how can the grabber or this arm will grab an object front. Let's see how can we do that. As we learned that this grab or this arm or this motorized part is connecting to a motor. And this motor, we call it the medium motor. And you can find the medium motor over here. It's connecting to port A. You need always to check if it's appear in the program or not, because if it's not appearing, then you have to check the wires. Now, the medium, this arm or motorized part, is connecting to the medium motor. Okay, and the medium motor is connecting to the robot using port A, which is over here. So I want you to see, I'm gonna remove the cable. See, the medium motor disappeared. I'll put it back. Now I can see the medium motor, which is connecting to A. Now I'll put an object in the front, or no need for the object. I'll show you how can I make this motor move up and down. To make it move an up and down, as you see, this motor is connecting to one port only. Then we have to go to the motors with the blue colors who are connecting or controlling, sorry, one motor at a time. So I'll take this one, which is saying that motor A will run clockwise, counterclockwise. This is the direction. Clockwise, it's going to be up and down in a direction. The counterclockwise, it will be in the opposite direction. It will turn or it will move for one rotation. So I'm gonna try this with you now. I'll put the arm up and then we will play the code. Okay, so I think now when we select it clockwise, the motor moves up, which is already up. So I want to change the direction to counterclockwise. Okay, so the motor moves hand or arm down when I selected counterclockwise for one rotation. If you look at the program here still like loading. And the reason, because the program, if you have another line, such as whatever, like say something, let's say like sound, it will play beep sound or another sound. I'm gonna stop this. I will play it again. Yeah. The program cannot read this next line. And the reason, because the rotation here is too much. The number, the value of the rotation is too much. I think if I hold the robot up, the robot has to finish the one rotation before it goes to the next line. So let's try to stop this value. Let's try to make it 0.5, which is half a rotation. Let's take this up again, all the way up, and let's say try. Should be fine. Yeah. So now I think the value of the rotation is satisfied for this this hand or this grab. I'm gonna stop it. Let's try 0.4. Let's try it. I think it should be fine. Okay, so this is how can I put the arm down. If I want to put the arm up, then I have to just copy command C, command V. I can copy this value. I'll make it clockwise. Okay, so let's take this down. And We'll play the program. Okay. Let's do it again. Okay. So now this is the action. Let me remove the sound. I'll remove the sound and want it to move up and down. I'll take it all the way up because I don't want it to affect the ultrasonic sensors reading. Okay, it moves very fast. Yeah, very fast. Okay, I can place like weight. I want the ultrasonic sensor, for example, to wait for seconds, wait for half a second. So I can okay, so this is how can I move the robot, the arm or the motorized arm up and down to detect something or to grab, something. Let's see that. Let's say the object front here. Okay. Thank you for watching.